Joe Budden's a legend, because as much as I dislike the pod and I'm not really a fan of the guy's content or him as a personality, so I can't really stomach his content, Joe Budden is fucking entertaining. Super entertaining. And I think the main reason why he's entertaining for me as a content creator is because I feel like he has no capacity for shame and embarrassment. He enjoys just being spoken about. Like, he's so sort of like addicted to like clout, fame and attention. He has no ability to feel shame and embarrassment. So because of that, he puts himself in funny situations that make for hilarious stories. That's what he does, because he has no, because us regular people will feel a little bit embarrassed and shy about certain things. Joe doesn't feel that way. So it makes for far better stories on pods. And this is one of the best stories of Joe Budden I've ever heard in my entire life, right? One of the ones that still makes me laugh to this point, from Yesjulz. Right, Yesjulz had this really interesting story about Joe Budden, and obviously you know Yesjulz and Joe have a bit of friction going on there. Some people allege it's because Yesjulz kind of curved Joe, who knows, but Yesjulz shares a very interesting and funny story about Joe that legitimately makes me laugh.
He would hit me up randomly just like to hang out or whatever, and I was just like never able to hang out. Then one night I'm in a movie and he calls me 3 times in a row, Joe Budden, randomly, right? I was with a dude I'm in a movie with a dude I'm seeing, and Joe Budden pops up on my phone.
How long ago was this?
3 times, which was like a couple years ago.
Okay.
So I pick up just in the middle of the movie, just so my dude knows, like, you know, it's nothing weird. So I'm like, yo, Joe, what's up? He's like, man, I'm at Kith right now, and they playing me. You need to tell your homie, like, they can't be treating me like this. I'm like, yo, calm down, what happened? He's like, nah, I'm about to give it to this cashier, man. You better call Ronnie and tell him right now that he's got somebody over here that's about to get beat. I was like, what happened? He's like, they won't let me return these sweatpants. And I was like, all right, let me talk to Ronnie. Give me a second. So I'm dead ass.
Listen,
and it's nighttime. I'm in a movie. He called me 3 times about some $400 sweatpants. So listen, so I call Ronnie. I was like, listen, Ronnie, you know I hate to bug you about this right now. And Ronnie is chill, Jewish man. By the way,
just to give you some, in case you haven't clocked onto what's going on, Joe Budden was trying to hit up Yesjulz to fuck, to date or something, right? For a while. It never happens. Then she randomly gets a call from Joe while she's in a cinema with a guy, and he's then starts shouting at her on the phone that she needs to get in touch with Ronnie Faye, who is the founder and the creative director of fucking Kith, to sort him out a refund because he purchased a Kith tracksuit from the store and he wants to refund it, but I think he wore it. Right, he wore the tracksuit. The store system wouldn't let him refund it. So Joe Budden went through his contact list and thought, who do I know that will know the owner of Kith? He saw fucking Yesjulz's number and called her. And then started screaming at her as if she's the fucking owner of Kith. Absolutely hilarious.
He hates drama. He's in bed by 9 o'clock. He's got his wife. He don't care about any of this clout shit. So I'm like, yo, can you do me a favor, man, and just call the store in Soho and let them tell them to let Joe Budden return those sweatpants.
It was open at that time, the store?
In Soho.
Okay, okay.
So I was like, yeah, let him return the sweatpants. So Ronnie's like, man, are you serious? I'm like, yeah, please, just do it for me. So he's like, let me call you back. Boom, boom, boom. Movie's over. Ronnie calls me back. Jules, my store clerk just sent me a screenshot of a picture of Joe wearing the sweatpants outside his stoop at his house. And I'm like, what? And I'm like, yo, send it to me. He sends me the picture Joe's wearing the sweatpants. So now he makes me...
Imagine, Joe Budden at this time is a successful podcaster. He's making money, right? He's a grown-ass man. And he's buying £400 tracksuits from Kith, which is already crazy. Who would buy $400 tracksuits? Crazy. All right, you bought them. But he's buying them, wearing them, putting the outfit up on his Instagram, and then trying to fucking refund them like they're brand new and haven't been worn. And then he's calling up a girl that he's been trying to fuck for ages to try to get her to sort out the refund for him. Honestly, Joe is legendary, bro. Legendary.
He looked crazy because he wore the sweatpants and he was, yeah, I wore them in a picture. I didn't like them. I'm trying to return them. I said, yo, I can't. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Or you just made me look crazy. And just return them because you got them off the picture. Because...
So, yeah. So basically, ever since then, we didn't really like converse after that, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of thought he was a clown.
Yeah, of course, duh. Imagine trying to hit up a girl again to hang out and shit after you just screamed at her over the phone to get her friend to let you have a like, honestly, man, Joe Budden is one of the greatest. I swear to God. Someone said Joe Budden's lack of ability to have shame is narcissism. Maybe it is, but it's fun to watch when you're not a fan. When you're not a fan of him, you can stomach his narcissism. But if you're a fan, it gets really annoying and it gets really boring really quickly. But if you detach yourself and just watch his content, it's kind of entertaining. I'm not going to lie. Oh, my God.